Hello, welcome. As you see, I have a forfait this morning here in this room. This is my third session, but I'm so proud to be in this special moment and to be with all of you, because as you know, this is the main moment in our IFLA life, this conference here today. You will say why? Because all of us, we were working together to have the best of our vision and our future. I'm not going to be long in my speech because it's just an introduction to tell you how proud we are in IFLA to have done this process with all of you. Because as you are listening these days from us, we all are IFLA. And this is a special moment, especially because it's shaping next 4 years. And this shape for the next 4 years' actions will be made by yourself. So I don't want to be long, and I'm asking now our Secretary General that was leading this process of starting on the global vision and now handing over with this important document that is our strategic plan. Thank you, Vero. Come to me.
Thank you, Madam President, and it's really a great moment for me to do this. I would say for me it's the most important speech in this conference which I am giving, and I'm really happy that you join me here at the grand reveal of our IFLA strategy 2019 to 2024, and to think what can we do together to make the library field stronger. First of all, I would like to give you just some small, a short overview about IFLA. Most of you know IFLA very well, but it's always good to get some information. We are the leading international body representing the interests of library and information users globally. This means we are representing IFLA at the most important organization, global organization like the UN, UNESCO, WIPO, in trying to advocate for you. But we are also advocating on regional levels like at the European Union, at the European Parliament. And we had wonderful meetings with Gloria Perez Salmeron, for example, in Latin America, where we brought together the ministers of the Latin American region to sign the Buenos Aires Declaration to support libraries in the work for the SDGs. This means, you know, IFLA is the global voice of libraries, and we want together be louder, because it's not the headquarters, it's IFLA is the voice of all, it's your voice. We are an independent, non-governmental, not-for-profit organization. We have around 1,500 active members, and that's great. We have members now from 149 countries in the meantime. This means we are growing. That is good to have 149 countries assembled, but as you may know, the United Nations has 193 members. This means still 44 missed. And one part of our strategy is, in these 5 years, we want to get all 193 countries of the world on board of IFLA to be part of the IFLA family. And this is an ambitious goal for the next years, and we reach it only when we work together on it, because you in your region know better who are the contacts, how can we get in contact with them, and how can we support them. We heard Mandla before talking about how difficult it is, especially in the developing world, to be a member of IFLA. We have to think about how can we enable libraries, library associations, especially in the so-called developing countries, to becoming members of IFLA. We have our headquarters in Den Haag, in the Royal Library of Den Haag, and I have the privilege to work really with an absolutely engaged team, with colleagues from 17 countries. This is really very special to work in such an international team, also with different styles of working. I appreciate it because we are a global organization. And I'm really happy that we are able to work with several regional offices located in Singapore, in Pretoria, and in Buenos Aires to work more together with the colleagues there in these regions. And I'm extremely proud that we are really taking care of multilingualism. Gloria spoke about before about the dominance of the English language. That is a fact. That's the new lingua franca, we say. But actually, many librarians in the world don't speak perfect English, and I am also not speaking perfect English. It's not my native language. And therefore, it's extremely important that we translate the major IFLA documents in all seven IFLA languages. And I'm proud because the United Nations have only six languages, and we have seven languages. But this is also a big challenge for us, especially we have seen it now in the creation of our new website, to translate all the documents, to have it only updated, and we can do it only with the support of language centers. They're doing it mainly for free, I have to say. This is a big support for us, and this enables us to be a real, diverse, global organization. Yeah, and this is it. This is the biggest brain trust in the library field here. We have 65 committees where 1,100 top experts are working for you, working on guidelines, working on ideas for you, working on support for you, and this is all combined in our PC, in our professional committee. That's great. This is unique. It's most global, and it is such a treasure which we have here on board. This means we are in a good starting point, but actually it was clear also in this discussion in the president's meeting of Gloria Perez Salmeron. We need change, because changing times need changes, otherwise we will not succeed. And IFLA is on a journey to a more open, inclusive, and participatory organization as before. We try, as it was in the discussion before, as Katharina said, to listen more as before, to hear in your voices and to bring in your ideas in. And we are on a journey from vision to strategy to action. And I would like to have with you a glance back how we organized the vision, how we organized the strategy. We are exactly there that we are launching today the strategy, and I would like to have a glance with you together in the future how we are organizing the actions. Clear this way. Vision, strategy, action. That is our way to go. Why the strategy now? I guess we have so many rapid changes in the world, in our environment. Think on IT, think on publishing. This all changed dramatically in the last 10, 15 years, and it's an ongoing process. But we have also many crises in our world, financial crisis, not only financial crisis. We had a great keynote speaker who gave us several ideas for it. We need change in this way, otherwise we will not survive. And what we have also, fortunately, I have to say, IFLA is in the comfortable situation that we, 2.5 years ago, we achieved a big grant from the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, which is a game changer for IFLA, because we can afford with this grant, for example, to organize a regional meeting, to be more in contact with you, to organize projects like the Library Map of the World, what we couldn't do before because the money was not there. But this means also there's a need for a new strategy to go forwards with it. And with all changes, create opportunities, but I know also on the other side creates also fears. And we must be clear, we would like to use the opportunities, and complaining is really not a strategy to change it. When you fear, you will be dead. Change, use the opportunities. Yeah, and this is, I think, really the slogan for us. The world's need for its libraries is as great as ever. I'm working now 30 years for libraries, and since the first moment when I came in, I heard always, libraries will die, libraries are out of use, it's a 19th century product or whatever they told us, our futurologists, and what it is, we are more vibrant as ever. But they were right. The library of 30 years ago doesn't exist anymore. The library is very different, and this was not in the head of our futurologists who predicted a wrong future. But what it means is also changing times need also changing libraries, and changing libraries need a changing IFLA. And this is the reason why we are thinking about a new strategy. And the best way to predict our future is to create it together. Not to hear what others are saying about, be strong, stay together, and create it together. This is the idea of our strategy when we are going from vision to strategy to action. Yes, and as I said before, in a different way, let's go it, as an open, inclusive, participatory organization. And to do this, we have to do exactly that, what we discussed before in the president's meeting. First we have to listen, and then we have to act, and not different. This is the philosophy of our new way we are going. And with this, we can successfully tackle the upcoming challenges when we join our forces and act more closely together. And the new strategy should enable us to do this. But let's look back to how we created the vision, with this philosophy first to listen and then to act. We created here the biggest and richest and most inclusive contribution to the future of the library field ever with this discussion. And there, it's really so. Never before has there been such an initiative. And we saw an incredible engagement that exceeded really all our expectations. A global answer to the challenges facing the library field from an ever-increasing globalization was given. And as I said already, we started it here in Athens. In Athens, why we did it? Because in Athens, as we know, democracy was born. And we wanted to start on a very symbolic place, like here, a discussion about a more open, participatory, inclusive IFLA. What you see here is not the Parthenon, as you may know. This is a piece of art. This is a piece of art which is very connected with IFLA. This is the Parthenon of books. And all these books you see in this building of art are forbidden books. And as you know, one of the principles of IFLA is freedom of expression, and we going for it. And this is so symbolic that we started this discussion in Athens here. And we started it at the lighthouse of the Niarchos Foundation, where we will have tomorrow our cultural evening. And it's so symbolic that we are back where we started our discussion when we are launching now our new strategy. And this was the start of this discussion. 137 top experts from our professional unit started it 2.5 years ago at the lighthouse. Who is here in this room? Who was at the start involved? Oh yeah, great, great, thank you. You have given really a push. But that was not all. What we did then is We reached out to all the regions. We organized workshops all around the world on all continents and invited their, especially library association and national libraries to get in contact, to get their views about how can we change the library world, a vision for, to create a vision for it. And this was an enormous start. Mandler spoke about in the president's session. It was for me also overwhelming to see library associations working together, for example, in Africa, in sub-Saharan Africa. When we started it, there were two groups, the French-speaking groups and the English-speaking groups. And in the first meeting, we did a lot of efforts to bring them together. In the second meeting, no efforts were needed. There were colleagues started it and pushed it. That is so easy to get such a development up, and it's so heartwarming on the same time to see such efforts. Yeah, but we couldn't invite the whole world to meetings, that's clear, but library associations did a great job. They organized meetings in their countries, brought this discussion out, and gave us reports back. What was enormous, and I thank really the library associations in all countries for this huge support in the discussion. And the result is incredible. When you see, we have here, we have the contribution from more than 30,000 people from all continents, from 190 countries included. There is no other thing like this, I have to say. And we can really be proud. And when we are going to other global organizations, they are really surprised that such a thing is possible. And I'm really happy that all generations are on board here, all library types are on board, and that we were also able to connect outside when we set up here our website and got the input from people from all around the world. Fantastic. This enabled us to produce the Global Vision Report summary, and we have here it with 10 highlights and 10 opportunities. This means 10 highlights where we are already good and 10 opportunities where we can get better. And this is created really all from you. We listened, and now we listen first, we produced it, and now we want to act together on this. This is it. The global vision is, with your impact, our guiding star, because there is no other document in the library world which is so rich as this and created by real the global community. And we feel the obligation as IFLA governing board and IFLA headquarters to follow you, what you said. This steered us really in the next time. But a vision without execution is hallucination. That's clear. It's a worthless thing. It's just a paper. And there are so many papers in the library world. I saw in the meantime, longer career already, so many papers in drawers. Useless. We don't want useless papers. We want actions. That is the difference where we want to go. This means clear next step from vision to strategy. And this was the reason why Gloria organized in Barcelona her president's meeting last year to start a discussion how to get the best ideas for creating a strategy. And this was again a meeting where we assembled all representatives from the professional units. A big thanks for you for this vibrant discussion which we had in Athens. And also big thanks to the officers of the professional units to organize then the discussion in their standing committees. We got so many ideas back. And we went out to the region and discussed again with the library association. Fantastic on all continents, this response. It was overwhelming. And this enabled us to create the Global Vision Idea Store. The Global Vision Idea Store is the biggest idea stores for actions and is intended to be a source of inspiration for all librarians and for IFLA in planning for the future. And you see here this enormous response. again from all continents, from all professional units, from so many library associations, and from so many individuals. That's incredible what there is in. This is such a treasure. And I give you now the number of ideas which we got. 8,500 ideas to improve the library field. And with this, we have the Global Vision Idea Store launched today. It's open. Go to the IFLA website. Get inspired, but inspire also others. Bring your ideas in. I'm sure you have so many ideas, great ideas what you can do, which can be a great example for others. Send it to IFLA. We bring it out. And I have to say, I'm also very, very happy. We have a wall of fame. We have really the people who contributed are named there. Come on it, be part of it, be proud that you also inspiring other people, colleagues of all in all continents. So this, the Global Vision, the Idea Store, gave the governing board so many ideas to start this discussion about the strategy and enabled the governing board to develop the IFLA strategy 2019 to 2024, which is really very different to all strategies which we produced before. It is a strategy created by you. You did it, and without you, this strategy would look very, very different, and it's a strategy for you. Just to give you an overview how it worked. We had the Global Vision discussion. We had other key documents, for example, the first IFLA membership survey, which we did a year ago. We have the Idea Store. Of course, we have other documents which are very relevant also from outside of the library world. For example, the Sustainable Development Goals. Of course, we are aligned with them because UN and we want together to improve people's lives in the world. And with all these documents and your ideas, the governing board started a discussion December last year to determine here priorities. We worked really hard, a full week on it, and the governing board created also working groups. They worked on it. A working group synthesized all and drafted a first version of the strategy. But as we said, we want to do it. We wanted to do it different. Listen and act. We had your ideas, but we wanted also to hear what do you wait? Is this, are we on the right way? Therefore, we consulted with all professional units and asked for feedback. And this feedback helped us, the governing board, to develop a strategy in a workshop in April this year. And with this workshop in April, we agreed most of the parts of the strategy already. We fine-tuned it a bit later. And I'm really now happy to present to you the IFLA strategy. Here it is, the IFLA strategy. And you see here many people from headquarters. They will deliver it now to you. IFLA strategy 2019 to 2024. And we will discuss it together in the next minutes. Good, let's continue. What we tried is to make complicated, complex issues simple. That is really the most demanding action, to make complex actions as simple as possible. And so we created a very simple structure for our strategy. Our strategy has, of course, a vision which was created by you, has a mission, and has four strategic directions. And each strategic direction, strategic one, strategic direction two, three, four, each of them has four key initiatives. This means we have 16 key initiatives and four strategic directions. And now it's coming to you. Each key initiative has activities. Usually they were defined from IFLA headquarters and governing board, more internally. This time it's different. What we are already doing at headquarters, we are working hard on it. We are defining actions and activities to support you. And also the professional units are doing. And I'm very sure when we are going out of this Congress with the work of the professional units, we will have already 200 action plans, 200 activities defined to support these four strategic directions. That is great. We have never had it before in this way. But what we want 1,000 actions. We want 1,000 action plans. And they can only come from you. You come in now. We will go on our website. You will find this on our website. You will find a template there in the next days, which you can download and write to us. How can you contribute? How can you become part of this global movement? What is your activities? How it is aligned with IFLA? So, you will not be surprised that the vision of the strategy is the vision you created in the global vision process. A strong and united library field powering literate, informed, and participative societies. This is our vision for the next 5 years. This we want to reach together with you. And this vision is supported by a mission. And this mission is defined, of course, very simple, what IFLA wants to do with you. To inspire, engage, enable, and connect the global library field. This is our mission for the next 5 years, to work with you. But I want to be also very clear. This is a strategy developed by you and for you. We want to inspire, engage, enable, and connect you. But we await also from you that you inspire, engage, enable, and connect your colleagues around you and that we are working together on it. So what are, and all this, of course, is supported by IFLA's core values. These are the values we are really committed and on we are working it. They are in our statutes and they are great and they're driving us really, these values. So, four strategic directions, very simple. Strategic direction one, strengthen the global voice of libraries. Strategic direction two, inspire and enhance professional practice. Strategic direction three, connect, empower, and empower the field. And the fifth one is a more internal one, to develop our organization better, to have a better sustainability for the future, more better membership, and also better finances, of course. When you see here, what I try to show you is how seriously we are taking this principle of listen and act. You see here, for example, strengthen the global voice of library. You see there are all these ideas included from the global vision discussion, the key findings, opportunities there. You see here, of course, we're building up on the strategic plan from before, because this was also a great plan, but we have now other challenges. You see here also continuity in this inside. And you see this at all strategic direction. It's very connected with what we got from you, also membership surveys inside. Principle of multilingualism is important for us to do it. And this is a principle which goes for all four strategic directions. I will not read here all, of course, but I guess there is so much in for you, for every one of you to contribute. And take the chance, take the opportunity, become part of a global movement. Even you, and I also ask you to optimize our organization. You will find here ideas where you easily can contribute. As said before, you see here these principles, four strategic direction combined with four key initiatives. This is defined. These four strategic directions are defined, and these 16 key initiatives are defined, as you will see. The activities should be defined by you. They should come up by you, and there should be thousands. And we want to have it, as in the global vision, from all parts of the world, because it's a global strategy from all countries. A global response to the global challenges which we have. And once again, be inspired, engaged, enable and connect, and inspire, engage, enable, and connect others. This is important for us. It is, as I said, a total new way of working, what IFLA is doing with you. But the success in this way depends on you. It's an enormous opportunity which members didn't have before. But you have now the chance, really, to go for it, to do it, use the chance, become here a member, because there is so much synergy. As I said before, IFLA headquarters and professional units are working already on activities to support you. We have 200 activities almost ready for you to support you. But what is important is that you are coming up now, that your ideas are coming again in, that we are doing together. This is synergy, because one activity supports the other activities. And that's not the end of the story. It's a call to action, a call to action to come for, like our former president, Donna Schieder, had this motto. You see here, we are going clearly from vision to strategy to action. And we started already discussions about more activities. We had a workshop already with all representatives of the professional units in June in Den Haag. And we will continue this discussion. And there was so much energy and so great ideas already to see. This drives us. And a central role will play again the library associations. We will organize again regional workshops in all parts of the world to discuss with library association what can we do for each other to become stronger. And we started this in a fantastic workshop in Buenos Aires combined with Gloria Perez, president's meeting in May this year, where we assembled the representatives from the Latin American and Caribbean regions here together. I guess 37 countries were there assembled, discussing how can we make the IFLA strategy to our strategy, also to the national strategies, and how can we create a better library world. And we will go on. We will, of course, do such regional meetings in all parts of the world. We will go, you see here already, several parts where we intend to go. This means we will have this year one regional workshop in November in the MENA region, where we will bring all together from the Middle East and North Africa, library association, national libraries. We will do next year a workshop in Africa. We will do a workshop in Asia, and we will do a workshop in Europe to invite all library associations to discuss it with us. Take actions, share your actions. This is the principle. And I guess it's such a chance for you, really, an enormous chance to become part of the global movement. This is a call for you. Join us, work with us, be part of the IFLA strategy, because we are IFLA all together. That is it. We have now the chance also for questions, of course. This is possible that you just raise your hand, and there will come a microphone, or there is also with Mentimeter, you can send us a question to answer. And what I would like you at the end, I would like you to then to invite all of you who want it to come here on the stage to do a picture together where you are on it in this historic moment of it, because it's your strategy, it's not my strategy, it's our strategy, and therefore you should come also on the stage for this picture then. Thank you. If are there questions? Oh yes, please. Can we get a micro here?
Κύριος είναι. The Parthenon of books, where is it? It's gone. It was a temporary. It was Castle, the Documenta.
It's from a Brazilian artist for the Documenta in Castle.
Right.
They are presented.
Ah, yes.
But
well,
I
thank
guess
you.
It would be nice also for library associations who are advocating to use this as a symbol, because a Parthenon of books which are forbidden and where all the wisdom is in is also very symbolic, I would say. Yeah. Any other questions? Here we are with a micro. Here in the middle, Frank.
Thank you, Gerald, for this wonderful presentation. If I may ask, you mentioned earlier a template which should be available on the website to help any librarian to use this new strategy. Is this template supposed to be translated into the several official languages of IFLA?
Yeah, as we all also say, of course, the IFLA website and the strategy is translated to all IFLA 7 languages, and it will also allow the template to do it there. Nevertheless, we would ask you to have a short summary, if possible, in English, because it would help us. Fortunately, at IFLA headquarters are working colleagues from 70 countries, I said, and we have almost all IFLA languages at our office, but we are missing two, and therefore it would be a help. Yeah. Yeah. What we did also in the morning in the highlight session, we presented more or less 80% of our new IFLA website, which we will launch end of the year, beginning of next year. And there our strategy will be presented very different to the web, to the strategy like it is presented today. It is today, it goes on the website, but with the new website, we will have much more possibilities to community, to network it, to connect it and to show connections. And what we will do then, we will bring all your activities which are coming from you for the IFLA strategy or for the joint strategy up on the website, that it is visible for all colleagues in the world. If there is not a question, write to me if you have or come to the booth, ask my colleagues. But I would really like to celebrate this very special moment with you, and I would like to invite you to come to the stage and to do pictures. There is no obligation to come to the stage. Of course, you don't have to be on the picture, but if you want to be, come on the stage and let's have a picture.
Gerald.
Be aware it's live streamed. This means when you don't want to be on the live stream worldwide, then don't come up on the stage. If you want to be seen globally, come up on the stage. Yeah? And take the strategy with it that we can wave with it, of course. Yeah. Hello, hello. Thank you.
تاخذ الوحده